Hi everybody, welcome back to my 100% walkthrough of Assassin's Creed Syndicate. On this video we are going to be doing another of the dreadful crimes solving. This one is called Next Stop Murder. And we find this one, where is it? It's down here in Southwark, in Lambeth, sorry. And it's right here, right near the viewpoint. Jump off the viewpoint and walk over to him, and then you will get the mission started.
Hey! Someone help! Some trap found something down there. Looks like foul play.
Oh dear. So we'll go and have a look at it. What looks like foul play. Jump over. And there we go. They found a body. It's an unmarked body. It's fallen from a great height, but there's no name on it. Over here we find a coat, a well-to-do, wealthy coat, like the man who's there, has got a name on it. That's Matthew Killian. Now the third clue on this area I found for ages. It took me ages to find it, but I shall show you where it is, because it's got to be done quite quick. You got to find it. You have to go right back up onto the bridge. And that took me a while to discover that that's what you did. And run along here, and you'll see on the bridge here, near where we are, there is, in this case, a pocket watch that has stopped.
I wonder if someone could tell me more about this.
So, we're going to jump down.
I wonder if someone can tell me more about this.
This won't kill you if you can do it. It will hurt, so be careful. And then go speak to this vagrant guy here.
I heard a splash, and right quick pulled this bloke out of the shallows, dead as a mackerel.
I live there now, if you can call it living. I lost my job, didn't I? No need for the likes of me when a machine can do the work.
The midnight train, that must be the 616, stops in the station down the road. If you hurry, it might still be there.
A nice warm coat like that on a dead man? What do you expect? I snatched it before somebody else came along to nick it. Like you.
There we go. So the next one is this station here. It's in Victoria, but it's actually Waterloo. I don't know why it says Victoria, it gets confusing. But it's Waterloo Station anyway, in the area that it is. So scumjet, all we gotta do at the station is speak to this guy.
You better hurry, it's leaving right now.
And now we have all the area is open to us. So you can see there's a train. We're going to go and jump on that train, and that's where we're going to do the rest of this investigation, on this train here. So in this restaurant car, we're going to look for some clues. The first clue is this, which is just a load of stuff saying down with industrialists and down with the monarchy and sort of anarchy type documents. This one is a newspaper talking about Matthew Killian, and it has a picture of him on there. And over here we have some sleeping pills.
I believe I should re-interrogate a suspect.
Okay, so the first person we're going to talk to is this guy over here. And his name is Peter. Let's do with him.
It was a typical evening. As far as I knew, nothing unusual happened until you came aboard with this story of a murder. I was tidying up in the passenger car. Around midnight, Vivian ran through. She thought someone was looking for her. Just another wealthy passenger. They're all pretty much the same.
Hmm. Okay. So now we're going to go and talk to the second guy.
Unusual. A couple of passengers came in had a sort of business meeting. One of them was buying a lot of drinks for the other, and then they started to argue. But Vivian went over and joshed them out of it. Peter, nice bloke. Came here after being sacked from a foundry a few months ago. I'll tell you, he looked white as a ghost after he served the businessman. Oh, well, it's a noisy train. Plenty of passengers have trouble getting to sleep, so I keep sedative here behind the bar, yeah?
Okay. So, once we've talked to him, now we're going to go to the next one. And there is one clue, but the clue is on the roof. And you'll find a boot, a shoe. What I didn't say is that the body had a shoe missing. And that is the shoe up there, look. So it's pretty clear what happened. It's a matching shoe. It's pretty clear what happened up here. So I jump down. And now we're going to speak to this gentleman.
Good thing, boys. Some noises on the roof woke me up briefly. You say someone was thrown from up there. You have to be a very strong... Vivian had another of her dupes in her compartment by then. After that, I remember people going past me from time to time, but I was half asleep.
Okay, so once you've spoken to him, we're going to carry on. Oh, I think we might have another one we missed there.
Killian was on this train?
Yeah.
Cool. I used to work at his foundry. I never even seen him. None of us workers ever knew what he looked like. Peter worked with me at the foundry. He's a very strong bloke. I got my arm mangled in one of the damn machines they put in. Then Killian sacked the old crew. Peter, he helped me get hired as train staff.
Okay, so... Don't forget, Peter went white when he's finished serving the rich guy. Okay, so here we are now. We're going into another carriage. There are a couple of things on here that we need to look for. Here's one. It's a gun. A Derringer with silver plate. I don't know what that's all about. And here there is a letter. That basically says Killian's on the train, he wants to sign the deal, make sure he doesn't do so. And then we've got to talk to two people. There's this gentleman, which is Mr. Wolf, but we're not going to talk to him, we're going to talk to his valet first over here, which is Sam.
Mr. Wolf had a few with Mr. Killian, then the young lady invited herself over to have a glass with him. Mr. Wolf became terribly tired, even though he'd only had one drink. He toddled off to bed well before midnight. I stayed in the dining car for a few drinks with the barman. Mr. Wolf bought him drink after drink. Then they got angry. But the young lady come over and it's obvious that Mr. Killian was interested in a rendezvous, like. Around about 11:30, Killian and her left together.
Mm-hmm. Now we go back and talk to Mr. Wolf.
In the dining car with Killian. We had business dealings in the past. It was a pleasant surprise to discover him on this train. I felt unusually tired and came back here to get some sleep. I suppose there were some disagreements, but there always are when a great deal of money is involved. Sam? He's a trusted valet. He's terrifically strong, which makes him useful in many situations.
So now we talk to Sam again.
I've been Mr. Wolf's valet for going on several years. He's frail and needs a man like me to help him about.
he's incredibly strong as well. And if you go into here, we've got one more carriage to check out. There's a couple of clues in here, and then a lady. So let's go to the first clue, which is over here. It's a letter from her sister, basically saying, "Have you got any more? You've got quite a caper going on." So that's going to give it away.
I wonder if someone can tell me more about this.
I think they can, Jacob. And on this letter is a note, simple note that says, "Come to the restaurant car quickly."
Now that I've seen this, I should ask more questions.
So let's go and talk to the young lady on the train. Who is Vivian?
Nothing unusual at all. I had a drink with some gents and then retired to my sleeper. Someone slipped a note under my sleeper door a few minutes before midnight. It said I should come to the dining car. I went, but only Ryan and Wolf's man were there, and they were both drunk. The rich fella, I did talk with him. Very charming. But a single woman has to be careful, you know? Did something happen to him? Oh, all right. I flirt with rich blokes, and the barman slips him a Mickey. I take him back to my sleeper, and they nod off before I have to do anything shameful. They wake up thinking they had a night of fun and hand me a few quid. That's what happened with Mr. Killian, but he was gone when I come back from looking for the man who left the note.
Okay, so that's a mischievous little scheme. We're now going to go and talk to Mr. Wolf again and ask him about the girl.
You mean the young lady? She and Killian hit it off famously. Embarrassing, really.
Okay, now we're going to go and talk to the barman, who is in on her little scheme, even though he pretends he's not.
That one. Clever little minx. She and the barman got a little scam going. I think everyone on the staff knows about it.
Sorry, that was Luke. That's not the barman. That's the other guy. Now we want to talk to the barman. He's here.
She's a frequent passenger, that one. Hangs about with the wealthier sort. Likes to entertain them, if you take my meaning.
I
helped Vivian fleece the dupes. I slipped a pill in the wine for the table. Both gents got sleepy, but Vivian picked the richest one.
But remember, every member of the staff knows about their scam. That's what they've said. And then we talk to Peter again.
She rides the train often. She's very friendly with the other passengers.
Doesn't say anything more about it. So, now we make an accusation. And I'm afraid, Peter, even though you're the nicest, it's you.
I gave him what he deserved. The man was heartless.
And there we have it. Peter did it to get him back for sacking him and all that kind of stuff. And the way he was heartless to the workers. And there's the Penny Dreadful that was written about it by Mr. Raymond. You can read that in your own time. But that is it. That is where we're going to end this video. Thank you very much for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe. And until next time, it's bye for now.